Well, they say if you can go to France or Paris, you can always bring it at home. Hi there, everyone. So, I love Paris. I wish I could have gone again this year to complete my trip that I started last year, but alas, 2020 and coronavirus and you know the rest. Anyway, so we can always do something Parisian or French anyway in our kitchens to remind us of the wonderful times we had there. So today, I'm making two dishes that I loved in France. One of them is a puff pastry. Some puff pastry that was stuffed with spinach and French feta. So I'm gonna put some flour here on the board. And you can either make your own puff pastry, but I don't fuss with it. I just get the frozen version, Pepperidge Farm, and roll it up a little bit, such. Make it all nice and sometimes it leaves a little bit of the folding marks here. Just make sure everything is nice and leveled. I have cooked a bit, I've cooked some spinach. I sautéed it with some olive oil, chopped garlic, and a little bit of onion. And spinach is a wonderful food, as everybody knows. That wonderful deep green is full of nutrients and iron. And it's a very versatile vegetable. You can cook it with eggs in the morning, scrambled or omelette. You can cook it on its own. You can have it raw in a salad. It's fantastic. And so right here we have sauteed spinach, olive oil, some garlic and onion, and I'm putting some wonderful, about half a cup or so of crumbled feta. I also love to add a little bit of dry mint, and this is something you can buy at the Mediterranean, Middle Eastern stores. They have bags of them. Just dried mint, and you kind of crumble it with your fingers. A little bit of salt and pepper, of course. Freshly cracked black pepper. A little bit of Himalayan salt. Mix it all together. And voila. That wonderful tanginess of feta cheese with the mildness of spinach is wonderful in puff pastry, in phyllo dough, in pita, anything you like. So I'm about to add it, and you kind of go closer to one edge because you're going to be rolling it over. As such. Kind of packing it a little bit like that. Smooth it out. Then from one end, you will roll it up like such. And you can fold it over like a burrito. Roll it up again. Then you always put the seam down so it doesn't burst open. You can do a few little incisions with a sharp knife, because once it starts cooking, it forms a lot of steam under the pastry and then it can blow it up. So the little incisions help the steam roll out of the pastry. And we will put that, I'd like to use a little sheet pan lined up with parchment paper. Put it in there. And I've got one egg beaten with a little bit of water. I'm going to use a pastry brush and gently brush it over our pastry. All around. Put in a 350 degrees hot oven until the pastry is nice and golden brown. I would say about 45 minutes. Every oven is different, so the best way to do it is to check on it every 20 minutes or so. Voila!